This is the hand grip heart rate monitor. It's used to measure your heart rate. So it's used in labs in the physiology manual, the biology manual that involve human exercise. And so you're using it to measure the heart rate. It's one that's a wireless sensor. It actually communicates from this hand grip from here, so you end up holding it in your hand, and it sends the signal from your heartbeat from here to this receiver, and the receiver is this piece. And so this piece is going to plug into, in this case, my LabQuest 2 or whatever interface you're using, and it sends the signal from here to the receiver, picks up your heart rate, and actually measures your heart rate and beats per minute and displays that. A couple of issues here in using this one. You'll notice that there is an arrow here. We suggest that you try to have this arrow in the same orientation as the arrow on the hand grip piece. And by holding it in the same orientation, you're more likely to get good data there. We also suggest that you hold the hand grip unit no more than about 80 centimeters from the receiver. So I can hold it like this and be ready to collect data. Sometimes we suggest maybe even taping the receiver down so that it doesn't move while you're doing this. It's also key that you maybe keep this away from other devices that generate electrical noise. A computer, for example, it can actually pick up the signal from that and give you an erroneous value, because all it can do is pick up some signal and be able to do that. So this piece, you obviously hold it in your hands. It has a battery in here, and it lasts several years. If it goes bad, there's some information in our technical information library about what size battery it is and where you get that. But they last for several years, and it's one of those kind of flat batteries there. So you're going to end up holding this in your hand, and it has a marker here that shows you where to place your hands. Your hands ought to be clean. Sometimes people will put lotion or something like that on their hands, and that can interfere with the ability for the sensor to actually pick up your heart rate. And because the way this works is it's actually measuring the slight change in electrical potential across your hands when your heart beats. So you become slightly polarized, and it actually measures that. And the device sees this slight increase in polarization, so it sees this voltage peak, and it just counts the peaks in order to calculate your the beats per minute, your heart rate. And so you end up holding this in your hand there, and it will pick it up. Sometimes, also, these can become dirty, so you might need to clean these to make sure that they are not coated with something that will stop this. So let's collect a little data. And as usual, I need to plug in my sensor. So I'll just plug it in here to channel 1. And we see here that the device comes up, and we see our meter. And it says heart rate there, and it says beats per minute. A common thing that will happen with this particular sensor is that someone's already been using, say, a temperature sensor or some other sensor, and they're accustomed to seeing a number show up on the meter screen. When you do this one, there's no number that shows up, because what it is, it's actually the beats per minute. And so it has to calculate the beats per minute. So it doesn't display any value until it's actually already collecting some data. Because what it's doing, again, is it's collecting those changes in electrical potential. So it's akin to actually measuring your pulse for a period of time and then counting how many beats you counted in a given amount of time. And so it's not uncommon for somebody to plug that in and say, wait, it's not working. Well, it doesn't show anything until you actually begin collection here. Let's take a look at our default collection parameters here. We see time-based, and so it's going to look at the beats per minute as a function of time. 25 samples per second is how fast it's collecting in order to see the heart rate. And it defaults to doing this for 10 minutes. We assume that you're probably going to do something, maybe doing some exercise, and so that's the default time is 10 minutes. We're ready to begin some collection. So I will go down here, and I will press the collect button. I'm going to hold this in my hands. And you'll notice there that there's a little symbol on the screen that's showing up there. What's happening, again, is that there's a lag between the time that it displays the heartbeat on the screen and me actually starting collection, because it's having to collect a number of beats for a unit of time before it displays the value. And so that's what's happening there. So as we go along here, so it kind of jumped up there, and it's showing my heart rate there. And so it's displaying, the default graph is beats per minute, and it's displaying that. So at this point, I could do something where I might start to exercise to get my heart rate up, and so I could, you know, dance around or do whatever and get my heart rate up. I think I'm just going to sit here for a minute and let it collect. And now I can stop data collection. So now that I have some data, we can take a look at the analysis here. And we see that this part, when I began collection and was talking, my heart rate was elevated. And then when I stopped talking and relaxed, that it dropped down to a different value there. I might be interested in knowing something about that numerically. Maybe I want to run the stats on this, and I could get my maximum and minimum heart rate, maybe the average heart rate over that interval. So to do that, I could go to Analyze, and I could go down to Statistics and check the box next to the statistics, and we see here in the meter, my minimum heart rate was 71 beats per minute at 170 seconds. The maximum was 114 right there at the beginning at 20 seconds. And of course, it would give you an average value there too if you wanted to. And so that would allow you to analyze the data there. So the hand grip heart rate monitor is used in the biology and physiology manuals to measure human heart rate.